used Aikido, by many considered to be the least effective martial art, 6 times in the Ultimate Self-Defense Championship, and I used Aikido 1 time in a real-life self-defense situation. The first time I used Aikido in the USDC was in the bus bash, where all the participants fought each other in a moving bus that was constantly swirling, accelerating, and braking. The Aikido technique came up during my fight with professional MMA fighter Jeff Chan, where he had me in a bottom position in an open guard. As soon as I saw his hand dangling in front of me, I grabbed and engaged a wristlock takedown known as Koregeshi. The problem here was that since I was lying down on the seat, my entire power came only from my arms, which is usually not enough to perform a wrist takedown. As for the best success, you should engage and use your hips and your entire core. Also, the fact that Jeff Chan is a professional MMA fighter did not help, as he was quick to defend his wrist. But the wristlock still made him pause and gave me an opportunity to improve my defensive position, making it a valuable technique. The second Aikido technique I used was much more successful. I pulled it off in the second challenge of USDC, during which I did not know how I will be attacked, as I had my eyes closed and could open them only when I felt a touch or heard a noise. As I felt contact and opened my eyes, my attacker was pushing me using his entire weight. Actually, an ideal situation for Aikido, where you're constantly taught to redirect committed energy. As soon as I felt his push, my Aikido instinct kicked in, and instead of fighting his push back, something that would probably only increase his levels of resistance and make him tense up, I stepped back and allowed his push to go through. I then grabbed his arm and head, stepped out of the way, pivoted, and let his push pass through while using his arm and head to turn him towards the ground. As soon as he fell, I used his lifted arms to enter into a mount and finish the fight. This technique, by the way, is known as Kokunage in Aikido. The third time I used the same Aikido wrist lock from the first time. This time I used it intentionally to improve my position, by forcing my opponent into the cage and using the superior position to punish him. Then, once overwhelmed by strikes, my opponent wanted to move away from the cage, I once again stepped back, pivoted, and used his arm and head to redirect him to the ground, the same way I did in the previous fight. This gave me a superior position that I used to end the fight again. The craziest part is that I didn't even realize I used any of these Aikido moves in the moment, and only figured it out once I was editing the footage after the championship was over. I guess it shows how something we trained for years does become instinctual. The fifth time happened during the beach challenge, where we had to either push each other out of the circle or drop each other on 2 knees or hands to get eliminated. This time I was being charged at by karate black belt and sumo wrestler Sensei Seth. Yes, he is a sumo wrestler, as he won 2nd place in the sumo nationals. Luckily, Seth was pushing me towards one side of my body, something that was completely down my Aikido alley, as I was taught for years to receive the energy of the push and to redirect it. That is much harder to do when a push comes on both shoulders, but when someone is pushing you towards a single side, as long as you don't resist, you can easily open up like a door, step back, pivot, and let the push pass through, which is exactly what I did to Seth. This way, I avoided him pushing me out of the circle while he was using his superior size and strength. Unlucky for me though, Sensei Seth has great coordination and body awareness, so he wasn't overcommitting to the push too much. And as soon as I let him pass through, he found his footing and was back in the game. That still saved me though, but if a less trained opponent would have applied the same push and overcommitted, it's more than possible that he would have stumbled out from the circle himself once his push was redirected. The sixth time I used Aikido was once again during the second challenge. This time, when 2 people attacked me at the same time, one choking me from the back and the other one hitting me from the front in the meantime. Once I kicked and pushed myself back, together with my attacker to the wall and defended his choke, we fell to the ground where I managed to escape his hold. As soon as I stood up, my Aikido instincts kicked in again, where I did not stay where I was to fight both of my attackers, but instead, I immediately moved in front of one of the attackers to block the path and line of sight from the second attacker to prevent them from ganging up on me, a practice I've done hundreds of times during Aikido against multiple opponents. As soon as the judges saw me doing that and moving closer to the escape door, they called it a win. Now, before we get to the time I used my Aikido in a real-life street cell defense situation, the Ultimate Martial Arts Journey Rash Guard, made in collab with X Martial, offering the perfect fusion of style, comfort, and performance, is out now. Whether you're a man or a woman, we've got you covered with both short and long sleeves options, all featuring the signature Own Your Journey slogan and the Martial Arts Journey logo on the back. Take advantage of a limited time sale of 21% off. And there's more. You can enjoy an extra 10% discount by using my exclusive code Rokas at the checkout for other cool products, such as a Goku rash guard, a tuxedo rash guard, these 2 unicorns choking each other out, and more. Click on the link in the comments to join the tribe and proudly own your journey.
And now for the time I used Aikido in a street self-defense situation. It happened during the time I was still running my Aikido dojo in my home country, Lithuania, where one night I was walking by a bar, which is known as the place where you go to if you want to have a fight. As I was walking past it, two drunk guys came out of it and blocked my way. They started talking to me, which I realized was their process of sizing me up, or in other words, deciding if I will fight back and if they would beat me up. A ritual I already went through dozens of times when I was growing up in the roughest city of my country before that. As I was making my conversation with them, it seemed that they won't attack me after all, but that changed when I told them that I'm not originally from the city. Then one of the guys proclaimed, "Oh, that means we'll have to beat you up now." As soon as he said these words, I saw the other guys starting to get ready for a fight. Now, the natural thing to do for many at this moment would be to start fighting. But every time you engage in a fight, you're risking that things won't go your way and that you will either come out from it injured or worse, dead. Instead of fighting though, once I heard that they will want to beat me up, I took a step back, I went into an Aikido stance, I pushed my arms in front of me and then seriously asked the drunk guys, "Are you sure you want to fight?" Being ready for their answer. Suddenly, both of the guys stopped. I could see their brains processing the question until finally, one of the guys extended his hand for a handshake. I shook it and we walked away in separate directions. While I did not apply an Aikido technique this time, it was the most Aikido solution, as the greatest goal of Aikido is to win a fight without fighting. If you want to see the Ultimate Self Defense Championship series where I used my Aikido 6 times, click on this video right here. And until next time, keep owning your journey.